And as his special guest this week, he has a Big Jerry Terry, an Adamsville Alabama, who has invented this new wonderful fishing lure. But some of you may be, you've hired someone. We have a special feature for you. We have Mr. John Terry to handle the closed caption for those of us who need some additional help. John Terry.
Big, fast, fast. First of all, for our listening audience and our TV audience out there, let me give a special thanks to Mr. Terry for sharing his day with us today. We brought him down from Muscle Shoals, Alabama, just to tell us about this wonderful, fantastic fishing lure that he's invented. It's getting worldwide acclaim, and I'm sure all of you are going to appreciate him describing this fishing lure to us. Mr. Terry, first of all, where'd you get the idea for this fishing lure?
Well, really, the idea came to me one night when I was having a drink. Yeah. Now, a lot of people wouldn't imagine that I'd have a drink, but I had two. And then I said, boy, I gotta find me something to fish with. Something you can just take that thing and cast it out there. And I drawed that thing back and I cast that line. And then I found out if you just kind of just slowly let that thing skip over the water, man, you could do something with it. And I said, the fish will bite that thing. Well, I skipped that through across there and the fish bit. I saw one time it just rolled its eyes in. Kind of cockeyed rolling. I said, you can do it. But then I said, I gotta get something about this thing where you can make it roll over. But I said, that thing's gotta be able to roll over while it's skipping. I worked on that thing and I worked on it. And there it went to rolling and skipping. Then I couldn't decide nothing about what size I wanted. And I said, it could be a bigger, or it could be a less.
But what size is it? What? Could you describe the size of it?
I got it about the size of Lawrence and Shire. It just about that size, I reckon. There it was.
Well, Mr. Terry, I understand that this has some special features in this lure as it drags slowly across the water. Oh. Does it do a lot of wiggling?
That thing will wiggle and shake. And you, if you go real slow with it and get fast, it'll jump up and it'll skip and roll over.
Out in the lake.
Oh man, I tell you what. And then I say if you use it, you better have enough sense to get out of the
Believe me when I tell them that I'm 79 years old.
Whoa.
lot of people ask me, how do I stay this young looking? Every morning I get up.
Bye, Mom.
One load of candle soup.
Serious, my boy, and my wife, which I'm not too proud of, is going to sing. We're going to sing. You hear we're going to sing.
Okay.
Okay. If we get ready, and if you don't like it, you love it. So, all right. Where's my boy?
Right here.
And that heavy chested woman. Where is she? Oh, there you are.
We're gonna start. We want everybody else to join in.
After
we get going a little bit, okay? Everybody's got to sing. Okay?
There's a penalty.
Yeah, everybody's got to help us.
I know what I am.
girl now, Don Devon.
This is the poopy list. The ghost poopy. The kind where you feel the poopy come out, but there's no poopy in the toilet. The clean poopy. The kind where you poopy it out and see it in the toilet, but there is nothing on the table. The wet poopy. The kind where you wipe your butt 50 times and it's still on one time. So you have to put some toilet paper in between your butt and your underwear so you won't ruin your own stay. This happens when you're done poopying and you've pulled your pants up to your knees and you realize you have to poop your pants. Pop a vein in your forehead poops. The kind where you strain so much to get it out, you practically have a stroke. The rest of that is running. It's worse. The kind of poopy that's so huge you're afraid to flush without first brushing it into with a piece of, into little pieces with the toilet brush. The gassy poopy, it's so noisy everyone within earshot is giggling. The drinker poopy, the kind of poopy you have in the morning after a long night of drinking. Its most noticeable trait is the skid marks on the bottom of the toilet. Gee, I wish I could poopy. The kind where you want to poopy, but all you do is sit on the toilet and fart a few times. The spinal tap poopy. That's where it hurts so badly coming out you swear to sleep in your sideways.
Say, Matthew.
You don't want to eat my mouth?
Oh, what's your name?
Y'all bring them back up here with bread.